Today, we are going to understand the AAC system for tool designation. Here, AAC stands for American Standards Association System. This system provides the tool signature or the tool designation. In early lectures, we are knowing for a single point cutting tool, the geometry has been formed due to the face, flank in the form of maybe minor flank and the major flank and the cutting edges. Now this geometry is a crucial geometry and we require to understand it because the overall performance of a single point cutting tool is totally depends on the geometry of that cutting tool. Now this geometry has been written in a specific and the standardized manner and this work has been carried out by different organizations in which the American Standards Association, that is also called as Machine Reference System or AAC system, the second Orthogonal Reg System or ORS system, and the third is Normal Reg System or NRS system. Now in case of AAC system, there are three mutually perpendicular planes we require to consider so that whatever the flanks and the face and the cutting edge, they have been made the geometry so that geometry we can interpret into that planes. So the first plane, which has been called as the reference plane, so this plane has been considered as a plane perpendicular to the cutting velocity vector. The second plane is a machine longitudinal plane in which the plane we have to consider as a perpendicular plane for perpendicular plane to the reference plane, and the direction of that plane should be in the longitudinal fit if we consider a straight turning operation. The third plane is a machine transverse plane, which is again a perpendicular plane to the reference plane, and its direction should be in the transverse speed if we consider again the straight turning operation. So these three planes we have to consider as mutually perpendicular to each other. So these three planes are been provided into this figure. The first plane, which is the pi r, so we call it as a reference plane. The second plane is in the direction of longitudinal field, so we call it as a pi x. And the third plane, which is again in the direction of the transverse field, so we call it as a pi y. So these three planes shows us the geometry of the major flank, minor flank and the cutting edges. Now with this figure we can understand the different angles which are being measured with the help of three reference planes. First of all, we'll understand about the reg angles. Now the two reg angles we are going to identify into this figure. The first reg angle, which is in the longitudinal plane and which is known as the side reg angle. Now this side reg angle, which is denoted by alpha s, so this angle is the orientation of the tool's reg surface from the reference plane and it is measured into the longitudinal plane, that is pi x. So this angle, which is known as a side reg angle. The second angle, which is again in the form of reg angle, which is called as back reg angle and denoted as alpha b. Now this angle is again a orientation of the tool's reg surface from the reference plane, but it is measured into the transverse plane. So this is denoted as alpha b into the transverse plane. The second two angles, which are been called as the relief angle or the clearance angle. Now the principal flank, it may be the side flank or the end flank. So these two flanks are being grounded, or we can say we are providing the grinding operation on the flanks so that we can provide the clearance that this flank should not be in contact with the workpiece. And for that purpose, these flanks will make the angles, and they are being shown with the notation as a theta. So in the longitudinal plane, we got this principal flank makes an angle, and it is measured into this longitudinal plane. So we call it as a side clearance angle or the side relief angle. The notation is theta s. As it is for side clearance, so we call it as a theta s. The second angle in the form of relief or the clearance, it is in the transverse plane. So here the end flank of the tool has been grinded, and we got the relief so that this end flank will not be in contact with the workpiece, and this angle will be measured into the transverse plane, and it has been called as the end relief angle or the end clearance angle, denoted as theta E. The next two angles are been formed by the cutting edges, and they are been measured into the reference plane itself. So the major cutting edge, which is just above the major flank, so this cutting edge is very important because it makes an approach into the workpiece. So that's why this angle is again called as approach angle also. This angle made by this cutting edge is been called as side cutting edge angle or the approach angle. The second edge, which is just behind, and this edge again makes an angle and which is measured into the reference plane. So this is the end edge, and that's why the angle formed by this edge, which will be called as end cutting edge angle. So these are the six angles in the form of rake angle, relief angle, and the cutting edge angle. And one more notation we are finding into this geometry, where these two edges, okay, these are joined together with the help of a radius. So we call it as a nose radius. So this way we can provide the different definitions for the angles, whatever we understand with the help of the figure in the form of ASC system. The side rake angle, which is denoted by alpha S, so this is the orientation of the tool's rake surface from the reference plane, and it is measured into the longitudinal plane, that is phi x. The back rake angle, denoted by alpha B, which is again the orientation of the tool's rake surface from the reference plane and measured into the transverse plane, that is phi y. The side clearance angle or the side relief angle, which is a relief or the clearance angle provided to the flank, that is side flank, major flank, in the direction of cutting velocity vector Vc, and which is again measured into the longitudinal plane, that is phi x. The back clearance angle or the end relief angle, denoted by theta E, which is again the orientation which shows the relief or the clearance provided for the end flank in the direction of again cutting velocity vector Vc, and measured into the machine reference, that is the transverse plane phi y. Approach angle or the side cutting edge angle, denoted in the figure with the notation CS. So this angle is very important as it approaches into the workpiece, and it has been formed by the side cutting edge. That's why we call it as the side cutting edge angle or the approach angle. So this angle is in between the principal cutting edge and the machine transverse plane, that is phi y, and which is measured into the reference plane, that is phi r. end cutting edge angle denoted into the figure as CE. So this angle provides again the relief that the cutting edge should not be in contact with the workpiece which is already been machined. So this angle is been called as end cutting edge angle. So this is the angle between the auxiliary cutting edge and the machine longitudinal plane, that is pi x, measured on the reference plane, that is pi r. And the last is the nose radius, which is in between the two cutting edges, that is side cutting edge and the end cutting edge. So this is we call it as a nose radius. So this is nothing but the curvature at the tool tip. It is to be noted that in ASA system, nose radius values is expressed in the inch. The tool designation and the signature in case of ASA system, which is provided in the form of the notations in a sequence manner, that is alpha B dash alpha S dash theta E dash theta S dash CE dash CS dash R. That means initially the back rake angle will be considered, thereafter side rake angle will be considered. So these are the two rake angles initially we have to consider in the manner of back rake angle, then side rake angle. Then the two relief angles will be considered as end relief angle and side relief angle, that is theta E and theta S. Thereafter, the cutting edge angles as end cutting edge angle and thereafter the side cutting edge angle. So CE dash CS, and lastly the nose radius will be there. So this sequence we have to provide consistently in case of ASA system for providing the tool signature. So in market, the geometry will be provided to the tool and the signature will be provided in the form of 0 dash, 5 dash, 6 dash, 6 dash, 10 dash, 30 dash, 1/12. If this is the signature which will be available on the tool, so it should be called into the ASA system as back rake angle for that tool will be 0 degree, side rake angle will be 5 degree, the clearance angle or the relief angle for the end side, so end relief angle will be 6 degree, side relief angle will be 6 degree, then the cutting edge angle, end cutting edge angle will be 10 degree and the side cutting edge angle will be 30 degree, and lastly the nose radius will be 1/12 of the inch. So this will be the example by which we can understand how to read the tool signature in case of the ASA system. Here the important points in case of ASA system we should always to be keep into the mind, that the clearance angle whatever we are going to provide in case of the tool geometry, so this clearance angle should not be zero or negative. So clearance should be there for the planks so that the workpiece will be get cleared from the tool. And the second important thing is that the range of this clearance angle in the market is about 3 degree to 15 degree. One more important thing, that is about the rake angle, and this rake angle will be a positive, a negative or even zero value. So in market you can have all the way, you can get the positive rake angle also, negative rake angle also, or even though we can say the zero rake angle tools are also available to the market. So clearance value should always be positive, and rake angle may be positive, may be negative or may be zero. So this is what about ASA system